Tomorrow should be a triumphant day for John Boehner, the day a new House of Representatives re-elects him Speaker of the House. But tonight, in the turbulent aftermath of the fiscal cliff vote, Boehner faces grumbling from other Republicans about his leadership. And an experienced Cincinnati political reporter, Howard Wilkinson, says Boehner is the man in the middle between rival GOP factions.
They're very much splintered. The moderates, you know, thought that John Boehner was bending over backwards to the Tea Party folks, the Tea Party caucus. Tea Party caucus thought that John Boehner wasn't going far enough.
Boehner's difficulties uniting such a divided party played out embarrassingly today when New Jersey Governor Chris Christie and New York Congressman Peter King lambasted House leadership, read John Boehner, for failing to vote on Hurricane Sandy relief. In mid-December, on the House floor, when Boehner had to withdraw his Plan B proposal because he couldn't get enough Republican support. But the unkindest cut of all, he voted for the fiscal cliff bill last night, while much of his party didn't.
Well, John Boehner has a problem, clearly. I mean, he had 151 of his 242 House members vote against this. And that doesn't look good for John Boehner. And, you know, there's clearly a lot of discontent among Republicans in the House about Boehner's leadership.
Earlier today, a Republican operative floated the rumor that Boehner was on the verge of resigning the speakership. Boehner's office denied it to 9 News. And Wilkinson doubts the talk about a challenge, too, though he sees Boehner as vulnerable after the fiscal cliff debate.
There doesn't seem to be anybody emerging as competition, but clearly he was wounded.
Wilkinson points out what we should all remember. There are more debates to come on spending cuts, on the debt ceiling. Boehner could, during those debates, turn around his fortunes, or he could face even more sniping from his own caucus. The deal that gave the Speaker of the House headaches could